So let's talk about technology and the internet for a second. There have been various mentions of ISIS using the internet very well. What's your impression of how sophisticated ISIS is in terms of using social media, using the internet? What's their reach? What's their digital reach?
I don't think that they're any more sophisticated than any PR team. They understand the value of social media in outreach, geographical outreach. They understand the value, obviously, of pictures with the beheadings, obviously, and the threat videos that they've created, where production values are pretty good on that. They're not geniuses. I mean, there's nothing special that they're doing that other groups don't do. They're doing things that we haven't seen other terrorist groups necessarily doing. So ISIS represents sort of this new generation that's grown up with technology and has used it, you know, individually for their own purposes in the way that teens and 20-somethings use technology, and they're simply adapting that for their needs here. I think that, you know, one of the things, the impulse seems to be to try and take down that kind of digital activity, to take down websites, to take down social media accounts, things like that. But that's actually one of the ways we track them. I mean, there's a double-edged sword there. They're using it for recruitment and things like that, but that's also a focus that surveillance can have to monitor conversations that are going on forums, to actually infiltrate those forums. We see it with this cybercrime forums as well. I mean, those are crawling with undercover feds, and that's what they're, you know, they're infiltrating them. And so on the one hand, you need those forums as sort of a centralized point to actually understand, in some regards, what they're up to.
So the hacker group Anonymous has announced that it's declared war on ISIS, and they're supposedly taking down websites and Twitter accounts and so on. Is that possible? And B, you seem to be saying maybe that's not desirable.
Well, I think it's problematic when Anonymous is doing it, because what kind of vetting are they doing? I mean, how are they determining that an account is an account that poses a threat in some regards? And there have been reports that they've actually taken down sites that are operated by academics who are doing research in the field, and they're probably taking down undercover sites that the military is operating in, that intelligence agencies are operating as well. So I think that their involvement sort of messes things up a little, because they don't really understand the environment in which they're operating. And really, taking down websites and taking down Twitter accounts doesn't accomplish much. It's whack-a-mole. You take down one and another pops up.